Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1542. Sakai Gradebook, extract points possible from square bracket 10.0. Hey, welcome back. It's another Mr. Excel Podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from MrExcel.com. Yesterday, we talked about a macro that would help to take this gradebook data and snap it into shape. Today, though, if you don't want to use the macro, maybe your gradebook isn't exactly like the Sakai gradebook. Well, we're going to take a look at some formulas. First of all, extracting the points possible from the headings. I want you to take a good look at these headings here in the formula bar, right? So the column's not wide enough to see the whole thing. Quiz C, number one, in square brackets, 4.0. That's the number of points possible in that quiz. And here there were 7 points possible, and 4, and 5.0, and 10.0, and 0.01. All right, so all kinds of different lengths of the points in there, but nicely, they all have the square bracket, and we can use that to our advantage. So we're going to say points here. We're going to create a student called points equal mid, the mid function of C1, comma. Where do we start? Well, we're going to use another function called find, the find of the left square bracket within C1. Close parenthesis, plus 1. So I want to go find that square bracket, go one character past it, and then how many characters do we want? Well, I don't know. I need 5, 6, 7, who knows? I'm just going to put a large number in there, and it will get me to the end of the string up in C1. So now we've gotten really good at getting the points possible plus a square bracket. To get rid of that square bracket, I'm going to use the substitute function. So I'm going to come back here and edit this formula. I'm going to say equal substitute. The string that we have is the result that we just came up with, and I'm going to substitute every occurrence of the right square bracket with quote quote. Okay, and so that says, hey, take that right square bracket, get rid of it, and now when I press Control Enter and we'll copy it across, it starts to look good. And the problem is, though, even though it looks good, this is still text. It's not numbers, and I can tell that by looking down here at the status bar. It says count equals 5. If those were really numeric, I would have a count and I would have a sum. The fact that it's giving just a count tells me that it's text. So we'll edit this one more time. We'll just say plus 0, adding 0 to that text that looks like a number. We'll convert it to a real number, and you see down here we now actually have a sum. Woohoo! All right, so we take that formula that's working, we copy it all the way across out to the last final there and column AE. All right, now that we have that, let's see, we're going to insert, I'm going to insert 4 columns here, so Alt-I-C for insert column, and we're going to put something called total. All right, total. Now, I just know that all of these numbers are filled in. That's a really good thing, so I can just use the AutoSum. All right, and it's safe to use the AutoSum up here again because I know that everything is filled in. However, if I was doing it for the students, that would not be a good thing to do because some of the students have blanks, and then the AutoSum might stop when it encounters a blank. So as soon as you hit that AutoSum, you want to make sure that it's going all the way back to column C. And now I'm going to grab that square dot and drag down. Actually, in Excel 2010, I could have just double-clicked, but earlier versions of Excel wouldn't do well because of that, the blank cells to the left. All right, so there we go. Now we know 422 total points possible and the score of each individual student. Tomorrow, we're going to take that and figure out what the percentage is. Now there's a wrinkle here, and tomorrow's formula is actually going to be a lot more complicated than today's formula. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another netcast. Mr. Excel.